The purpose of this video is to give you a brief overview of boom cards and show you how you can find and get boom cards to put into your boom cards library. I'm going to do a separate video on how to use the boom cards with students, and I'll link that in the description box. But right now, the purpose of this video is just to show you what boom cards are and how to access them. So boom cards are basically interactive flashcards. And what I mean by interactive is that the user can manipulate the flashcard to provide the correct answer or desired outcome. So all boom cards are very different. I just wanted to show you a boom card to give you a general idea of what I mean by interactive flashcard. So this boom card says, which is the smallest? So the user would select the smallest. And as you can see, there's a reinforcing sound and color, and then it moves to the next card. So now the card says, which is the biggest? So the user would click on the biggest one. It does the same thing and moves to the next card. So again, by interactive flashcard, I mean the user can either click or manipulate the items on the card in some way to provide the desired outcome or answer. There's many different boom cards covering many different topics. So in order to get a boom cards account, you will need to go to boomlearning.com. I will link the website in the description box as well. You'll need to sign up for an account. When you're on that website, it will give you lots of information about the different packages available and how to get an account. And once you have an account, your interface will look like this. So you'll have different tabs at the top. And right now I'm in my library. So your library is where all of your boom cards go that you've purchased. So right now I'm teaching ESY. I teach pre-K ESE and we're in the middle of ESY. And these are the boom cards that I use with my students. So this is my library. So there's a couple features I'll show you. I'm not gonna go into everything because this is a beginner video on boom cards. But like I said, this is my library where my cards go. And something nice about the library is you can actually create folders in the library to organize your boom cards. So right now it says all, so you're seeing all of the boom cards I have. However, I teach pre-K ESE and we focus on language, so I split my boom cards up into language folders. So if I'm working with a student on a specific language skill, I can click on that folder, and then those specific boom cards will come up. So you would be in your library and you can create a folder by just hitting new folder and titling it. So I'm just gonna name this one practice, hit okay. And now that practice folder is in my library. So if I move my boom card by clicking it and dragging it to the folder, now that boom card deck is in that folder. So again, most important parts of this part of the video is library, all the boom cards I've purchased. I can create folders to organize these boom cards and I can drag and drop them into the folders. So in order to actually purchase or acquire the boom cards, you need to go to the store. So we're in library right now. I'm gonna hop over to the store. And this is the boom card store. You can search for cards by author. So if you have a favorite author, you can type their name in the search bar, or you can search by decks. So if you don't have a specific author, but you know what subject you're looking for, I recommend you look in decks. So for the purpose of this video, I'm gonna look for shapes. When I do that, when I type in shapes, all of these boom cards come up. And as you can see, there's tons and tons and tons of boom cards. It's really overwhelming because there's so many. So if you look at the boom cards, you'll also notice that each boom card has a point value. And that is actually equivalent to a monetary value. So any boom card with a point value over zero does cost money. So in essence, you're purchasing a boom cards membership to access the website, and then you're purchasing the boom cards individually. So for example, if you search for shapes and you find one you like, You can click on it. It'll give you information about the boom cards deck. So the name, the author, the price, the grade level, and how many cards come in the deck. So every deck has a different amount of cards. And it'll give you a preview. Once you find a deck you like, you can click add to cart, just like online shopping. So now if you look in this top right-hand corner at the cart icon, our boom card is in the cart with some others that I've been looking at. So similar to online shopping, once you've found all the boom cards you want, you would just click buy points and check out cart. This will prompt you to put in your information and pay for the cards. And once you do that, the cards will end up in your library. So right now we're in the store looking for boom cards. All of the boom cards, like I said, that have numbers underneath cost money. What's really nice about boom cards is there are tons of really free, amazing boom card decks to choose from. So a feature I always use, because I'm on a teacher's salary and I love to save money, is I sort by price. So once you've typed in your subject, you can sort by, click on the dropdown, and hit price low to high. Now, if you look, all of the boom cards that come up say zero, which means they're free. And if I keep scrolling, you'll see how many free boom cards there actually are. So there are tons and tons and tons of really great free boom cards. So not to knock the ones you purchase, those are great too, but I definitely recommend checking out the free ones first because you might find what you're looking for free. I know that you can purchase boom cards from Teachers Pay Teachers. I'm not going to cover that in this video because I'm keeping this really simple, but if you have questions about that, just leave me a comment. So when you're looking for boom cards, once you find a boom card that you really like in the store, you can click on the boom card. So I'm going to click on this boom card deck and I'm going to look at the deck. So this is about matching shapes. It's free and it's for pre-K and there's 21 cards. So I've decided I'll take this one. Now, how do I put it into my library? The great thing about free boom cards is that you just click the green add to library button. You don't have to add it to your cart because it's free. But again, if you're purchasing one that actually has a point value, you'll need to add it to your cart and check out. But anyways, this boom card set is free, so I'm gonna add it to my library. I'm gonna hit add to library, okay. Now the boom card is in my library. So if I go to library, there's that boom card deck. If I wanted to go back to the store to purchase more or to look for more free boom cards, I would just click on store again, scroll back up to the search bar and type in my next topic. So now I'm looking for colors. So now all of these awesome boom cards are coming up for colors. And again, I'm gonna organize it by price. So I wanna see the free ones first. And all of these awesome boom cards are coming up for free. I'm gonna click on the boom card I want. I'm gonna add it to my library. Awesome. So now I'm gonna go to my library. And if you looked, there's our shapes boom card. And there's our colors boom card. So they're both now in my library. So again, in this video, we focused on learning about the library, seeing where our cards are, how to create folders to organize our library, and we focused on searching for things we need in the store and either buying them or getting them for free. If you have any questions, leave me a comment. But this is the general gist of how you would access the boom cards and how you would get them to be in your library.